5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and we're live once again. It's the foul mouth Kahan Tazadaq is in your midst. And this is the Truth Won't Make You Mad podcast. And check this out right here. Ladies, you must submit to your man. If you want true happiness, you want that man to love and respect you, you have to submit to your man. You can't just half submit, right? Either you're all right or you're not right at all. Either you're all right or you're not right at all. So submit to your man. Now, a lot of women, you know, you come up with all types of excuses why you don't submit to your man. Why you can't submit. Oh, he's this, he's that. And so, and this is why many women are not content, they're not happy. And you can't keep a man. Why? Because you refuse to submit. You've taken on westernized standards and you honestly believe that, okay, it's 50-50. 50-50 don't equal success. 50-50 equals divorce, has been proven throughout America. One in every two marriages end in divorce. Why? Because they believe, first, the monogamous relationships don't work, by the way. Monogamous relationships do. Okay, we got some people that want to come in here. Let's see what they got.
Hello.
Peace.
Hello.
What's going on?
Nothing much.
So what do you think about the topic, sis? A woman should submit to her man. What do you think about that?
Yeah, a woman should always submit to one man. I agree with that, I'll be real.
Yeah, same.
The average woman doesn't agree to that,
Emerald,
though.
You can't be talking, I can't lie.
I couldn't hear what you say. Could you repeat that again?
Bro, are you a bot or something? Are you an AI?
No, I'm real.
Are you like in the army or something?
Okay.
I agree that
a woman should submit to one man and one man only.
Okay, so hold on. So you say a woman should submit to one man only? Are you saying that man should have only one woman?
Of course. Especially the man, especially the man can have anyone else. You know what I mean?
Well, repeat that again? A man can have what?
Like when you're dating someone, you should both commit to each other, you know what I mean?
But where are you? Let me ask you, where are you calling from? Where are you at? Where are you located?
Where's Amali?
Are you an Africa?
What?
Where did you get that philosophy from? Let me tell you something. You're never going to meet a man that commits to just one woman.
Nah. Stop talking. I already met someone who only commits to me.
First of all, you don't come on here and give orders. See, you're already out of order. We're just talking about submission, and you're telling me to stop talking.
Stop putting your fingers on me.
You're muted.
Oh, like he's being busy.
I'm pointing my fingers at you. Because your mouth is saying one thing, but your brain is going sideways. In fact, he's just talking about submission. If you get that weave out of your hair, maybe you could think clearly. You got too much on your mind. That weave is obstructing your mind. It's clouding your thinking.
I didn't even say anything. So why the fuck are you coming for me for?
No, I'm not talking to you.
Don't do that. Don't
put
your fingers at me. Who the fuck do you think you are?
I threw a stone, right? If it doesn't apply to you, you don't get hit. But if it applies to you,
what does my wig have to do with
you? You gotta absorb the blow. You understand what I'm talking about?
But can I ask you something?
So this is, see, right now, sis, you're being double-minded. Because you just said a woman should submit to a man, but you come on here trying to give me orders.
I never said that. Did I come out of my nails?
The only thing I can see is the top of your weave. Like, but I don't know if you're trying to propel or something with your hair, your weave. Yo, give it all of the weave and wear your natural hair. You're much more beautiful.
Can I ask you so old?
You're
can
much
I ask
more
you
beautiful
so old?
With your natural hair.
What does my hair do with you? Like, is it affecting you? Like,
what's your man never weave?
What does my hair have to do with anything?
Let me answer you what your hair has to do with it.
A real man, if you got fake hair, you got on makeup.
Well, I do. I do have one. So now what?
You're gonna get what you're putting out there. You get what you put out in the uniform. If you put out fake stuff, that's what you're gonna get back in.
Why is he talking? What the hell?
That's how I talk. Why do you think why I'm talking? I'm talking because I need to be pulling money.
People are only coming for me. There's two other people in this line.
No, I'm not just talking to you. You're pointing to you.
No, you are talking to me. Like, go away. Stop talking to me.
I'm talking to the lady up top. I'm not even talking to you. Initially, I was talking to the lady above you with the black hair that's only showing one eye, like she's some part of like the Matrix. Or a Cyclops or something. She only got the one eye photo. You understand what I'm saying? I don't know if that means she sold her soul or what. Maybe she's been in Hollywood. I don't know. But she just got one
eye. Sold your soul. Mimi, you sold your soul.
That's what they do with the one eye photo. You understand what I'm talking about?
You sold your
soul. So yes. It sounds like. Hey, Big Play Visual, where you at, huh? They gonna get this work. So where you guys calling from? Okay, her, Mimi.
Can I say something?
Mimi, where are you at? Why are you hiding your face, Mimi? Mimi, why you just showing the one eye photo? What's up with that? My soul's not for sale, man. All right, I'm going to say shalom to you guys, man.
They out of here. Let's get the next ones on here. Let's get the next. You see what I'm talking about? They talking about submission. But you trying, hey, well, you think you're talking to, you point your finger at. You believe a woman should submit, but you can't even do it. You can't even come in order. Eve is off, man. Her spirit is off. See, that's a prime example. She look colorful, man. Now, you know, disrespect, she like a clown, huh? How can she think that's attractive? You understand? They look like clowns. Hey, Justice Raheem, I sent you the link, King. I'm going to send it to you again. Big Play Visual. I don't know what you're saying. I'm not live, man. I don't know what's going on. You It's your device, man. You need to throw that joint away and get another phone, huh? What? NKC is back in the building. Big Play Sims can't do nothing, man. I just had three of them on
the phone away.
I just had three of them on here wilding out, huh? Wilding out.
Yeah, evil, I see now.
They fixed the phone with self-esteem issues. They weren't really up there trying to be serious. It wasn't serious.
Still kind of breaking up, huh? Your device is still kind of broken up. You know what I mean? Like the new addition to somebody. It's breaking up like you're the new addition. You know what I mean? So, again, ladies, when you come on here, show some decorum, but don't come on here and try to give me orders, baby. I'm a real man. It's not going to fly with me, man. You don't give me orders? I don't take orders. If I wanted to take orders, I would still be in the workforce. I always had a problem with authority, man. Nobody, no man rules over me but my supreme Allah Hayim. You understand what I'm talking about? And it's definitely not going to be an Eve, and I'm not coming with none of that 50-50. You're going to understand your position, man, when you're with a real man, and your position is under your man, running from your man. Because everything that you learn, sweetheart, I hate to bust your bubble, you learn that from a man. And if you learn that from a woman, she learned it from a man, man. You call me misogynist, call me whatever, man. The device that you hold in your hand right now was created by I, man. Was created by man. If you're on a computer, it was created by man. If you're watching me from a television, it was created by man. You understand what I'm talking about? I, man. So you're gonna respect men, whether you like it or not. But I tell you, you better like it. You're gonna respect men, and you're gonna like it. Dig. Yeah, you laugh, but it's true.
They're gonna be like,
oh, you can't tell me what to do.
Yeah, I mean, so, I mean, and your backup comes from a man. The only reason that we're not running around in a primitive stage because certain men have to protect you. So you better respect men. Understand that. Now, you never had a man to talk to you this way because 80% of you, men and women, you don't have a father in your life. So you hear men like me say, oh, wow, that's scary. Because you never had a man. I sound like a real man. And then some of these dudes that was raised by frauds, well, no, God, I'm a man. And yeah, why? Before you get your panties all in a wide, dude, you bow down and you listen to. Because you need a lobotomy also. You understand what I'm talking about?
They actually hate their fathers.
Yeah, so the one that say I talk too much, come on here and say something that's relevant. Freely, vlogs. I talk too much, like, come on here. You're listening, though. You're listening. You're attracted to it because you're listening. But you can't resist it. You can't resist it. The truth cuts hard. You understand what I'm talking about? Feminism is done. Khan Tazadaq is in your midst. Feminism is done. It ruins your life anyways. This is why you have so much delinquency. Since feminism has, you know, came on the scene, there's been so much teenage pregnancy, delinquency. Hey, justice right here. Everything is good, man. I'm telling you, it's working. Oh, hold on. We got some people in the background. Let me get them on here. Let me get them on here. Huh?
Justice, that's right. They got your son.
Come over here. I don't see you in the background. God, pardon myself. God. Nate B, come on the call. Scam likely. Let me get him out of here. What was you saying, King? God.
I said, is they going to get on?
Oh, what up?
Well, somebody came in.
What to do?
It's scam likely. It does what it does, man. We're going to make it do what it do. We don't ask what it do. We just do it. Like Nike. You understand what I'm talking about?
You talking to me?
No, I'm talking to you.
Hey, what's up? You inviting me on here. What's up?
We're talking about the subject matter. What are you talking about? You was in the invite group, so I invited you on here. The subject matter is a woman should submit to her man. That's the subject matter. That's what we're talking about.
Submit, right? I think other people have different definitions of what submission
is. Nah, listen, we're not going to tap dance. There's a general definition for submission. Well,
yeah.
If you have aphasia, then it's probably not for you. Well, so don't try to tap dance like, well, what do you mean by submit? Go to Webster's Dictionary and look up the word submit.
Yeah. Yeah, man. I mean, you can submit your enemies in war. You can submit someone in the UFC ring, and someone can submit by following your leadership, your tutelage. I mean, there's a couple different.
So
not the same.
I hear what you're saying, but we're not talking about getting violence with women. So why would you bring up war, combat, and UFC?
I'm saying you asked for the different definitions.
It's general knowledge. A woman submitting to a man doesn't mean, you know, to a common thinking man, doesn't mean a man putting a woman in a UFC lock or going off the combat.
Of course, and I didn't assume you were talking about that, but like I said,
if you don't,
can you give me your picture of what that looks like?
If you don't want to discuss something, don't bring it up. We never mentioned any of that. Cool. We said a woman must submit to her man. In the practical sense, the obvious would generally go to mom. Not all of those other little things that you mentioned it about wars. Come on, man. This is not for tap dances, man. This is not
so
for
can
tap
you put
dances.
That in your own words? So
Let me ask you this, brother. Were you raised by your father?
Yep. Father was a Marine over 10 years.
Okay. So if he was a Marine, likely wasn't around a lot.
Why would you assume that?
Because I've been in the military and you deployed.
When I was younger, he was in the military before I was born. Yeah, I had my life. Yeah, for sure. We still got to.
So, let me be honest with you, King. If your father was in your life, and your father was a real man, because just because someone was in the military doesn't make him a real man. I know a lot of Marines that didn't have a father figure in their life, right? Then your father would have taught you that you do not be with a woman that doesn't submit to you, because that's a problem. Understand this.
Yeah. Submission I never went against that. I want to submit to respect.
If he doesn't respect you,
can you tell me what it is in your words? Say what?
If she doesn't respect you, she won't submit. The reason that a lot of women don't submit to men because they don't respect them. And they've been taught not to. You know why? Because guys like you, because minds like yours that try and tap dance for women and try and justify. Word. Yeah, word, word. They're trying to justify their behavior.
I simply ask you to tell me what is submission in your eyes? What is your own definition? What does it look like for you?
No, it doesn't look like anything. It is what it is. Submission, a woman submitting to a man is her respecting the man, her cooking for the man, her cleaning to the man, her recognizing the man as her leader, not her equal. That's submission. In fact, the word itself requires the woman to acknowledge the man as her headship and submission. There's no equality. So when people start talking equality, that's not submission.
Okay. So you married right now?
Of course.
Okay. Let me help you out, King.
I'm not just married to one woman, by the way.
Yeah,
that part right there. Yeah.
Were you going to tell me the number? How many wives do you have?
That's irrelevant. So, So I'm not one of these dudes, because I already fill your spirit out, right? You're one of those men that like to throw the captain save a help and try and save these women when you should try to be reforming them, because they need lobotomies. The vast majority of women in this day and age need a lobotomy. You understand? And I'm hard pressed to believe that you was really raised by a man that was a Marine with a mindset like you had, because you keep trying to rescue Eve. And Eve is the reason that this society is so degenerate. That's why there's so many male delinquency. That's why there's so many teenage pregnancy. And minds like yours are not helping it. You're aiding to the destruction of our
community. Hey, brother, you know what? You came in before you even started your live. You came in with a narrative to push. You said that a woman should be submissive. I said I agree on that. But tell me, what does that mean in your words? And then I simply asked you, are you married, brother? And then you told me, and now you're telling me, women need a lobotomy and you're trying to save hoes.
I pretty much agree with what you said. The fact that you question whether she needs to submit means that you're in contrast. You see? That means you're in contrast. The fact that you need me to decipher the word to you, unless you have a phaser, it means you're in contrast. That's general knowledge and general logic.
Nah, man, I simply wanted to hear it in your own words, because some people may think submission is, like you said, cooking, cleaning, and all that. And submission may also be of the mind. Like, hey, I'm your leader now. This is how it's going to go. There's different terms of submission. It's not just one. It's not a monolith. It has different ways to break that down. So
submission is not being combative.
Push it then. But don't sit up here and tell me who I am, because I ask questions.
Define submission. Define submission.
Victoria,
you got a dictionary with you?
No, I don't need it. Submission to me is a willingness to
Not to you, because you didn't write the dictionaries. We're not concerned about what submission is to you. When you look at the etymology of the word submission, what does it mean?
I don't have that in front of me, but to me, like I said, it's a willingness to be led. It's a a giving up of certain power to a more dominant one, to form, let that one make the decisions, let that one lead. The one is in control and one is not. That is submission to me.
That's to you, but that's not what the dictionary says.
Submission. For sure, and that's fine.
So listen, this is the fact of the matter. The average woman you talk to in this society is going to want the man to be her equal. And relationships don't work when there's equality. That's what you need to understand. Westernized civilization has ruined our communities. Equality equals divorce. It does not equal a successful marriage. Because any organization, the family unit, is an organization. And so every organization, to be successful, it has to have a leader that ultimately is going to decide when there's disagreement. If that organization doesn't have that, it's going to self-destruct. Just like a business organization. You have to have a leader. You pass it through many different levels, but if they can't agree upon something, then the leader of that organization is going to make the ultimate decision. So it is with the family unit. The family unit have to have that leadership, that headship. So with, let's say, around the late 60s, early 70s, that began the destruction of our communities. When this feminism nonsense was pushed and this equality. Prior to that, if you look at Blackstone's commentaries, if you look at all the laws of the land, there was none of the equality stuff. Everything that belongs to a man was considered to be his property, to include his wife. Which could be really validated with the Ten Commandments, if you believe in the scriptures.
Yeah, so I agree on that, but more so than the feminism movement, because if you want to talk about our community specifically, the feminism movement was never for black women, because black women had to work and earn the entire time. It was the white women and the other ethnicities in this country that got to sit home, and during World War II, oh, we want to be in power, woo, woo. That's what, like, but black women were always predated the feminism movement to having to move like that. Now, when you talk about our community specifically, we had the highest marriage rate before welfare, before Section 8, when they tell you the woman can have a home, but the man cannot be in a home, or else we're going to take that home away for you. That is really where the divide split at. If you want to really like get to the root problem, you got to look at what this government has done. But I definitely agree. You know, you hear these women, oh, I'm powerful, I don't need a man, woo woo. That ends up that makes weak children when they're brought up in that mindset. I do.
So let me ask you this, King. Did the woman have an option in that? Let me tell you something. I'm not giving these women a pass. You know who's responsible for that? The woman. The woman is. Because she had a choice whether to choose farewell, welfare, right? Because that's essentially what it means. Reverse, farewell. Right. Or to be with the man. Mm-hmm. She chose to get it. Listen, they tried to destroy our families with slavery. Didn't work. They tried to destroy it with birth control. It didn't work. What worked? The so-called black woman going to college and the so-called black woman donning that feminism. That's what destroyed our families right there. That did it. And she did that voluntarily. No man did that. She did that. She made a decision to do that, right? And now as a result, you can look at the families that utterly destroyed. Utterly destroyed. But she made that decision. We can't blame the government because she had a choice in that process and she made a decision to do that. And so that's what needs to be reformed. So they need a revolution of their minds, man.
So when you bring up college, what do you like? Do you say that as a way that college afforded black women to have more opportunities? So they sometimes they become the breadwinner over like blue collar work. Like, why did you bring up college?
Yeah, that's not even true. When you look at that statistically, that's just something that they throw out there to deceive people that don't do their own thorough research. So the aphorism, well, I can't even call it an aphorism. The facade that's being pushed is that the woman is making more than a man, which can't be founded anywhere, huh? Because when you look at the median salary for the average man last year, it was around 50,000 and a half. And all women are making 13% less than the average man. So that means they're somewhere in the 40s. That's on an average level, huh? That's on an average. So despite them going to college, the first thing is that most of them that go to college don't major in fields that's going to be productive. And so when they come out of college, they're already in debt. to have a huge student loan. Some of them are actually enticed to go and get a mortgage, and most of them are not even married, right? So now when they look for a man, they're typically looking for a man for a financial crutch, right? Sometimes love is not even involved. So they're looking for him to pull them out of that. But the facade, it seems like they're doing well, but they're really not doing that well. They're really not. They may be growing, but they're not there yet. And college has been one of the most, one of the worst things that's actually hit a blow of death to our communities, because they're not educating people that go to college. They still don't know how to manage finances well. Look at most of these people that went to college, they're in very deep debt. They're in a deluge of debt. And some of them be paying student loans off until they're in their 50s and 60s, and some of them never pay it off. And on top of that, they're taught to go out and get a mortgage and a car note. So they're already in debt before they come out of college, because they got to start paying back the student loan. And so they keep putting it in default.
I got a question for you. So in terms of the black community being, because right now I think we are matriarchal, and I think we have been. Who do you blame the most? The systems at hand, black men or black women, for us being matriarchal?
Oh, well, we're not in a matriarchal society, because, and that could simply be proven by 90% of custody cases are awarded to women, right? 90% in the court system. So 90% of the children go to the women, but statistically, it shows that to be worse. Statistically, it shows that a single parent father is always the better parent in most cases, because they're less likely to be delinquent, they're less likely to be suicidal, they're less likely to be involved in drugs and narcotics. But with the woman, it's just the reverse. So the court system knows that, but they still reward it to the woman.
I agree. I actually agree on that. Sure. I think if there's one parent in the household, I think the father benefits, because, you know, you can raise a man to be a man, something a woman can't do. And your daughter, you know, you get to tell your daughter all of the things that, you know, men, all the negative things, you know, that you're going to come across, how the ways men think, you know, and so forth and so on. Whereas I don't really think, I don't know if you ever had a dog, right? You ever had dogs, and the woman, like my daughter or my mother or my girl cousin, like, they can't call in my dogs from the house. But when a man does it, it seems like they respond. And not to compare anyone to a dog, it's just like the authority factor. It's like, it's kind of like the same.
Right. Come. Yeah, but I'm just saying, I think part of the problem is that not enough men are telling women, you want to be with me, you're going to submit. Or you can go and be with him. See, you got to think, 80% of the women want 10% of the men. Because if you talk to the average woman, even if she's an average woman or just below average, she wants a man that's making $100,000 or more.
They're going to try to come off on child support and grab that, get that bag.
Yep. It's just what it is. These are the facts. So we can't continue to give Eve a pass anymore. Eve needs a revolution of her mind, man, which is complete constructive saying. But there's one thing that you said, when you say the so-called black woman has always worked, that's not true. Because I watched my grandfather and other men go to work while grandma was home baking food and all of that. In this day and age, a lot of these Eves put their husband on a microwave diet.
Mm.
He's living off of processed food, man. And wonder why he only used the bathroom twice a week. Because he's not eating whole foods anymore. She doesn't know how to cook. And some of them make mockery of it. It's like, oh, you're not a cook? I don't know how to cook. Like it's funny. But it's really not funny. It's pathetic. Because what man would marry a woman that doesn't know how to cook? And that's been reared by a woman. Right? Because a lot of men that's been reared by women, they have the same mindset of females. So who's responsible to fix it? The man. Real men have to stand up and say, listen, we're not going to tolerate that anymore. You're going to stop dressing like that. You're going to put on something that's less revealing. and you're going to conduct yourself like a woman.
And what do you think about the other side, right? So we kind of spoke on what, you know, on the woman's side. What do you think, men? Well, how can we do better? Like, you know what I'm saying? Because a woman, yes, you can lead a woman, but if you can't lead yourself, then you can't lead a woman. You can't lead a family. You know what I'm saying? So let's talk about the options that's out there as well. What can the men do to prepare themselves to be better, to put themselves in a position to be a leader? Because most of these dudes are followers out here. If you're a follower of someone else, then you can't lead anyone. Even a child.
I got you. Check this out, okay? Let me ask you this. The average man that you encounter, let's say this, above average, the average man that you will encounter has been raised by a single mother. So that's part of the problem right there. The reason he's a follower is because he doesn't know how to be a man. He just don't know. And so we can't know what we don't know. So he has to be taught that. Most men, it is a fact, has been raised by single mothers. And on top of that, a lot of these women, they raise these men to hate their fathers. They lie on them. They fabricate stories. So I'm going to just shift the blame where it is, man. She needs to be reformed. Yeah, a lot of these men need to be reformed, but they can't even hear it because they've been raised by the single woman that we're talking about. Right? And so now they're developing that same mindset. Listen, when I was coming up, man, we played football, basketball, you know what I mean, baseball, you know what I mean, stickball, all of this. But now they stuck on the computers. Look how many overweight teens there are. It didn't used to be like that. Why is it like that now? There's no father in the home. Society, you know, social scientists and psychologists have stated over again, man, that the greatest problem that we have in this earth is the absence of the father in the home. They said that most problems could be resolved if the man was in the home. They know this, so they strategically keep the man out of that home. How do you do that? You teach the woman that you don't need a man and make her believe that it's part of her own thinking. So it's repeated again and again so many times that it becomes part of a psyche. And then she begins to think that she's thinking from her own accord, but she's been psychologically manipulated to think the way that they wanted to think.
Nah, I definitely agree with you on that. Hey, when you say con, though, like, I heard
other people
yes. say that. What's that mean?
My bag. It's a habit. That's a Paleo Hebrew word that means yes.
Okay.
And they're modernized. What was that, King?
You deal with the 12 tribes?
Oh, yeah. Con.
For sure. I got a few of my best brothers is you know, Israelites.
I don't remember.
Nah, man. Hey, it was good chopping you up though, brother. You know. Since you a follow, man, you actually had a lot of great points. You know what I'm saying? I'm glad we got to have this conversation.
All right, brother. Yeah. You too. Likewise, because I never know who's coming at me, so I always come off with a lot of masculine energy, man. But you sound rational at the end. But I thought you was the dudes, man, that would come and save Eve. But, you know, the men, it's up to men to fix the other men. You know what I mean? Because sure. Eve can't do it. She just can't do it, man. So men are really going to have to sit down and talk to the young boys and try to, like, I don't know, role model them or something, man. That's the only way. So even if a boy doesn't have a father figure in his home, if he got an uncle, if he got some male figure in that community, she should allow him to be around him so he could learn how to be a man. To take on those masculine traits. And that's exactly. On everything I love, King.
A coach, a teacher, or somebody, you know what I'm saying? It's important to be out here in these communities.
Right. Yep.
But definitely appreciate you, brother. We'll tap in with you another time.
All right, peace. Be safe, King.
Where are you too?
Oh, we got someone in the background? All these invites. So many Eves is back here, man. I let them all pass up.
Oh, you ain't see it?
No, I didn't see it. I'd be in the spirit, huh?
Careful, left.
Yeah, they all vanished now. Huh? It was a lot of invites in the back.
In the comment section, listening.
Yeah, they listening. One chick was like, yo, you talk too much. Yeah, all right. You getting it, though. You getting this work.
So he sound angry.
Yeah, I do. That's just how it's taught. It's masculine. Oh, you're so angry. It's terrifying. Yeah, you're right. That's how it's taught. It's just my energy, man. Call it what you want, man. Call it angry. If there's no contention, there's no anger. You know what I mean? It's just how it's taught. It's the masculinity. You know what I mean? Some of it takes part of me if I made you wet. But that's just how real men shoot. They... Gone. All right, y'all, I'm going to have to end this, man. I'm about to get twisted up. So I'm about to say shalom, man. Peace and love, man. And appreciate the king for coming on, man. If I offended you, I meant to.
Till next time.